So hello everyone, in this particular video tutorial we'll learn about the PIG. We'll introduce you with the PIG programming language, the PIG data flow language, the PIG, the architecture of PIG, of big data. So PIG is a very widely used and very well-known tool of big data. It's a big data processor. So we'll learn it one by one with this slide, that is how and when and in which way we should supposed to use PIG. So what is PIG? PIG can be defined in six different terms. One by one we'll see that. The first point is that it's open source. It means that it's freely available to you. It's a high level data flow system, unlike MapReduce, which is low level, you know, programming language for big data processing. PIG is high level. It means that you have to write very small lines of code, very small specification of the code to execute a big task. It's a high level programming language and it's a data flow system. Data flow, having said that it's a data flow system, it generally means that the data flow of PIG programming language happens one by one. So it's like a command based programming language. So there will be supposed 10 lines of PIG code is there. So the first line and its execution will determine the execution of the next line, and the output of the next line will be taken as the input to the next line, and so on. So it's a kind of system of data flow. This is the first specification, the first definition, the first generalization of PIG programming language. We'll learn the next one. That is, it's a high level language provider, and the name of the language is PIG Latin. So basically PIG, the term PIG for big data, comes with two different concepts. One is the PIG architecture, which is separate from MapReduce and built upon Hadoop. Another thing is that it has a particular program, it offers a particular programming language, and the name of the programming language is PIG Latin, which is a query based simple programming language. So these two are the terms for PIG programming language. Yes, these two are the terms we use to define the term PIG in general. One is the PIG architecture, another is the PIG Latin. Next thing is that we need to write scripts using PIG Latin. So whenever we execute some PIG related queries in any specific, we can execute a PIG query in three different ways that I'll explain you later. So whatever the way of execution you make for PIG, you should supposed to write PIG script for that using the PIG Latin language. Generally, the next point is, generally it is used with the Hadoop architecture, that is on top of Hadoop, like the MapReduce works as a processing part of Hadoop. Similarly, PIG works on top of Hadoop. So basically PIG program is actually compiled and then executed like a MapReduce job, which executes on top of the Hadoop only. So it's an abstraction over MapReduce. Abstraction means hiding something, right? So it hides the details of MapReduce. So in front of the users, it's appeared to be a very simple lines of code, which is based on user defined functions and PIG Latin specific commands, which will be converted automatically internally by the PIG architecture, by the PIG compiler, to the MapReduce task. So it's an abstraction over MapReduce. Next thing is that the scripts are converted to map and reduce task. So a PIG Latin script will be converted, will be, you know, after compilation will be changed and will be modified in terms of map reduce task, into the map task and reduce task, and it will be executed above the map reduce paradigm. Big companies like Yahoo, Google and Microsoft, they use PIG. Why I'm writing this point, that is big companies like, why I'm telling this point is that you can determine that any particular language capacity by the users of it. Like a mobile phones users determine their, you know, financial and technical goals, correct, and financial and technical capabilities. Similarly, the companies which use a particular language defines the language actually, that this language is that much important. So the big companies like Yahoo, Google, Microsoft use PIG. Next, we'll learn about the need about the Apache PIG. Why do we require Apache PIG? So there are many reasons why you require. The first thing is that the programmers actually suffers a lot when they code in MapReduce, because it's a very difficult task to convert a particular problem into the map task and reducer task. Sometimes you need to define partitioners and combiners. in between the mapper and reducers. So these things are very difficult tasks. It requires complex knowledge of programming in Java, and sometimes if you can code also in Python. But that thing is not required if you use the Pig Latin, which is a very simple language in comparison to Java and Python. And we don't require much complexity to write down the code also. That's the first need and the first reason why we learn Pig. Now, Pig Latin is a SQL-like language. You know, SQL-like means SQL is a structured query language, right? For DBMS programming, we have learned this. So in SQL, what happens, each and everything is specified by 9 basic commands, like select from, create table, insert into, update from, delete from. So these commands are used, commit, correct, na? So here in this particular language, Pig Latin language also, we can determine any problem by using certain SQL-like commands. Some commands we use, like use SQL, we'll use certain commands, like, so here also use certain commands. So based on this, commands, if you know the commands and if you know about the execution style of SQL, it will be very easy for you to learn Pig Latin also. Yes, now, along with all this flexibility and easy, and ease in programming, and simplification in execution of a particular big data task, MapReduce and Pig's performance is at par. Yes, for the big program, the raw MapReduce and Pig works, performance is almost same. Now, Pig provides the data operations, like we have the filters in Pig, we have joins, we have ordering, and we have lots of the different data model. The data model of Pig provides different types of the data types, the nested data types. We have like tuples, that is rows in a table, rows in a SQL. What do you mean? Bags means the collection, actually, collection of rows and columns, values, actually, rows or subset of rows are known as the bags, which is provided by Pig. Similarly, we have maps. Maps is nothing but key value pairs. These things are missed in the MapReduce. So for a big data specific jobs, these data types are actually very specific. So no need to do any complex lines of code through MapReduce. The same thing can be achieved easily by using Pig, because Pig provides already those data models. So it is easier for you to code the same thing and achieve the same objectives which you can achieve through a very complex lines of code using MapReduce in Pig Latin. So definitely it's another reason Pig Latin is easy to write and read. And you know, multi-query approach of Apache Pig Latin, you know, it reduces the length of code. And it reducing length of code, sometimes 10 times less lines of code is required than Java, than MapReduce. Are you getting 10 times less? So if you have solved a job in 1000 lines of code in MapReduce, that can be done in 100 lines of code, or maybe 50 lines of code sometimes, depends upon the problem. That makes our development time quite lesser. Sometimes 16 times lesser time is required for coding in Pig Latin. So if you do something in MapReduce in 16 days, the same thing you can done in single day and in a single odd day in Pig Latin. So definitely you will go for Pig Latin, right? So these are the requirements, these are the need why you go through with the Pig Latin programming language. The next thing we'll learn about the features of Pig. So features are lots of features provided by Pig, which makes us to learn Pig language, Pig Latin language actually. So one of the things is that it has the rich set of operators. Yes, for joining two different tables is very complex in MapReduce. Shorting and filtering, all these things, it becomes very easier actually to have these operations in Pig Latin. So for, you know, as it is similar, Pig Latin is similar to SQL, and it's a structured and it's a data flow programming language, scripting language. So those who are known a bit about the SQL-like programming languages, actually database programmers, they know already SQL, right? So those who are hearing and watching this video, I think 90% of you know about the SQL and have gone through with the few of the statements of SQL, right? So for you, learning Pig Latin will be very easy. Next thing is that, you know, optimization opportunities. Optimization happens by Pig architecture automatically. It is provided by Pig architecture automatically. So you have to just go through with the syntax and semantics of the programming language. Optimization will be done automatically. You don't need to bother for that. Yes, then we have the lots of operators. Yes, you can develop your own, you know, read process and writing data specific functions, because we have lots of the operators available in Pig Latin. So in this way, extensibility of the job is achieved. Now we have the user defined function. It's one of the advanced feature of Pig Latin programming language. So this user defined functions can be defined using the Pig Latin programming languages, Pig Latin programming language, and based on that you can execute lots of different types of jobs of big data. Yes, another advantage of that is the user defined functions even can be embedded with non Pig Latin programming languages like Java, Python, JavaScript, and actually the user defined functions are supported by 6 programming languages outside Pig Latin. So you can define the Pig Latin programming, user defined function in those particular languages and can execute from there. And another reason why you should supposed to go to the Pig Latin programming languages, that why you should supposed to use Apache Pig, is generally it can successfully deal with the unstructured and structured and semi-structured data. Yes, you can take the data into the HDFS and can execute, and even in the local mode you can execute in the Unix file system, in your local file system as well. So that's the advantages and that's the features of Pig. Now we learned about the history of Pig. I don't want to spend much time over here. It started in 2006. Yes, as a research project, it was started by Yahoo. Yes, they want to reduce the complexity of MapReduce jobs actually. Yes, now it was open source later. After 1 year, it becomes the open source. Means each and every worldwide developers can develop and contribute on the project of Apache Pig in 2007. That is also started by Yahoo. And Apache Incubator actually started that. Yes, the Yahoo project has been taken by Apache Incubator and they have open sourced that. And as a result, the first release of Pig came out in the next year, 2008. And in 2010, Apache top level project is assigned and registered with the programming language and the architecture Apache Pig. So 2010 onwards, it's on the market. So where we should supposed to use Pig? You try to understand that each and every programming language and architecture is not suitable for each and every problems. So definitely for each and every architecture is suitable for some cases and it's not suitable for some cases. We'll learn first where it should supposed to be used, where it can be used properly, where it is suitable. The first thing is that it can be suitable when the data loads are time sensitive. Next thing, it can process various data sources because Pig can have these capacities. Then when analyzing the insights, through sampling methods and all, so it can be used like processing and all, you can use Pig on those cases very easily. Now there are some cases when it is not suitable to use Pig. We'll learn that thing also, we'll not hide anything. When the data is completely unstructured, like we have the document data sets, we have map data set coming from the Mac or satellite images, or very complex from the data set from the scientific experiments, or the data coming from the images or videos or audio sources. So the data will be completely unstructured for those cases. At that kind of cases, you should not supposed to use Pig. Yes. Now when there is time constraint is available, that is in this particular time, within this particular time, this particular objective has to be achieved through programming. Suppose Flipkart and Amazon, they are competing for gaining the business insight that which product will give them more sales and more profit. At that time, you will not use Pig in general terms, because Pig is slower than MapReduce. It will take much time because Pig programs are compiled by the Pig architecture, Pig compiler, and then it is converted to MapReduce. Then it works like a MapReduce only internally. So it will definitely take more time than the MapReduce. Yes. So when there is such kind of time constraint is available, that is this kind of output should be the output of this particular objective should be achieved within 5 hours. Suppose that kind of constraint is there. So that time you should not supposed to use Pig. Yes. Now, when more power is required to optimize the codes, and that time we should not supposed to use Pig. So these things are advanced things, but for the basic things, what you learn in big data and in the basics of big data or in the intermediate level of the big data, we should suppose to know the applications, right? That's the most important thing over here. So we'll focus over here, the applications of big. So when we use the web logs, now what do you mean by web logs? You know, each and every web server has a web log file. It's the, by default, they have. What is a web log file? It's like a register of your lab. When you get inside the lab, you write down your name and your detail, one time you are getting inside the lab, when you are going out of the lab, each and everything you write now inside a registered book. So web logs are like that. Whenever a user visit that particular website and click on some of the URLs, immediately in the backend, that is in the web server, the web log file will be updated with a single line of specification. That single line of specification will have the IP address of the user, the name of the user, at which timestamp which particular URL has been clicked, which HTTP method is used, GET, POST, or whatever it is. Then how many bytes are downloaded, which particular HTTP methods are used, and all the data related to that particular user will be stored. So when we process this web log, we actually focus on getting some information. For example, we want to see that how many users has clicked on our newly optimized website's special section. Suppose the section is the sales. The sales section is there in a e-commerce website, suppose. And you want to see that from last 24 hours, how many users have clicked on that particular sales part. So that time you can analyze the web server log file or web log file in simple term and get the insight from the data set. Yes, so when we require to process the web logs, Apache Pig is a very, very nice example. We can just have a single line of code. You have to write down load space, name of the data set where it is there, and using Pig storage, which particular syntax you're using. Actually, in web log files, the data like the username, then user IP address, then user's timestamp, all the data will be separated by a semicolon. So you have to just write down this Pig storage within the bracket semicolon. That's enough. The web log file is now loaded to your Pig storage and ready for processing. It's such a simple thing to process web logs using the Pig. So for web log file access and processing, we can use Pig programming language and the Pig architecture and Pig programming language. Now, when you require data processing for search platforms, yes, for search platforms, you know. So for search platforms, when you need data processing, we can use Apache Pig. When you require ad hoc queries across large dataset, ad hoc queries means whenever a query is created out of some special need on the fly. For example, I'll give an example of ad hoc networks. For example, you just think that you four people are there. Okay, you and you, okay, you four people are there, okay, so you four people want to connect among yourself your mobile phone. So how we'll do that, you'll open your Bluetooth and connect among yourself, na? So whenever you are connected, you got some movies or some songs and distributed among yourself, and then you go out of the classroom. When you go out of the classroom, you are disconnected. So that network becomes the ad hoc networks. For a particular job, you connected the network, you come out of the classroom, out of the lab, then you disconnected the network. So it's an example of ad hoc networks. Similarly, when you require some particular job to be done, some particular query to be executed, you use some particular, you know, stuff, some particular lines of code you execute, and then a particular query you obtain. So this type of execution of query known as the ad hoc queries. So across many data sets, you communicate, you connect, and you make the query, and after the query, you get some particular insight of the data sets, and then you release the data sets, you close the data sets. For such kind of queries, Pig is very efficient. Now, quick prototyping of algorithm for processing large data sets. When we process large data sets, we need prototyping of algorithms. Prototyping means, suppose you have to test the algorithms. Will this algorithm work for this type of the data set? So what you can do, a small part of the data set you can take from the real world large data set, a small part you take, and a real world algorithm you take and you prototype for that particular, you test or optimize or change the algorithm for that particular smaller data set. That thing can be done by using the Pig programming language very efficiently. Now we'll see one case study how Yahoo uses Pig. See, Yahoo uses Pig for the following purpose. First, in pipeline and in research. In pipeline, it brings the logs from its web server, where these logs undergo a cleaning step to remove bots, company interval views, and clicks. This is a single line statement, na? It's not very easy for you to understand, I know, if you don't know about the log files. I just explain you about the web server log files, correct? So you know about the web server log files. But what do you mean by cleaning step? We cannot take the log files directly because there will be lots of the nonsense data, missing data, unwanted data. So we need to clean the web server log files. The first step to clean the log files is to remove the web bots or web robots, also we say. So what do you mean by this bots, web bots? Bots are not users, but they appear to be a user. They are actually created as an automatic program. Yes, it's like robot program. It is created by different companies for different purpose. Search engine like Google also create bots, and those bots are the ethical bots. They created and sent to get the structure of a particular website. That from the root of the website, what are the different pages are there? Inside that pages, how many other pages are there? It sees the structure of a particular website. For that, Google and Yahoo use the bots. But there are some unethical bots also, unethical users. They send bots like to create user account. Yes, to click on a YouTube's particular pages, to get more watchers, to get more views, unethically. Yes, so you should supposed to know these bots and remove them. Yes, so the company interval views and clicks, all these things can be properly get by first removing the robots. So it is done in pipeline. So it is basically an application of Pig for web server log file only, that I explained in the last slide. And in research also it used. Why Yahoo use Pig for research? It actually tests some theory by using Pig. Suppose the theory is there that in this way, if we access the big data, this particular benefit we may get. Suppose the theory has been designed by some scientist. Now to test that big data specific theory, a Pig script can be written, and on the data set it will be tested. Yes, why will not use any other programming language? Because Pig scripting is easy. Pig, then the programming using Pig Latin programming language is easy. So we can test a theory very quickly, other than writing it to Java program, the Java code or Python code or Perl code, and to run against the huge data set. We take the smaller data set and we can write down a small Pig Latin script. It will be quick. So in this way, Yahoo use Pig. So when I'm telling about the Yahoo, let me tell about the Twitter also. I have not put that thing into the PPT because one example, one case study is enough to make you understand. Just for your knowledge, you should supposed to know that there is a website, social media website known as the Twitter. Yes, Twitter also use Pig. Why Twitter use Pig? To see that which particular users are making which particular comment on which particular topics. Yes, they also collect the data from their server, and they short out the user's ID and user's name. And then they check that on which particular number of tweets they have made, and many other details actually using Pig programming language. Well, we'll go to the next topic. We'll not go through with much case studies. It will be a waste of time. We'll first compare Pig with the MapReduce, SQL, and Hive. So its comparison will make you understand the thing very clear. Actually, that's why I kept the comparison at the very beginning of the slide. I planned to keep it at the end. Then I feel like, if you understand the comparison, then it will be very easy for you to understand the Pig programming language. So first difference is that with the MapReduce is Pig is data flow language. It's not a data processing language like MapReduce. MapReduce is a data processing paradigm of Hadoop, right? It's a data processing part of Hadoop, which process the data in terms of the two functions, map function and reduce function. Also, we can define partitioner and combiner functions also. But Apache Pig is a data flow language. It means it flows the data from one line to the another line, one step to the another step. So as MapReduce is a data processing and the basic component of Hadoop, it's a low level programming language. It's rigid. You have to write complex code, but Apache Pig is a high level programming language, because this the output of Apache Pig programming language is converted to a low level programming language of MapReduce only. The output of Apache Pig code is a MapReduce code only, which is having map and reduce task. Another thing is MapReduce. Now join operations will be very difficult. In Pig is quite opposite. The join operations are very simple. We have lots of operations, operators for that in Apache Pig. We'll see it when we'll go through the practical session. We'll see it how much it is easy to make join of two tables, but joining two tables are quite difficult in MapReduce. Now Apache Pig is simple. As I told before, Pig Latin is very simple for the new programmers, beginners, because they know about the basics of SQL, means it will be more easier for them. But for MapReduce coding, exposure to Java is required, and quite good quality of the coding you should supposed to know for MapReduce. Now the Apache Pig use multi-query approach. Yes, the length, multi-query approach makes the length of the code 1/16th or 1/20th or sometimes 1/30th than MapReduce code. Now that the last one is, there is no need for compilation. There is no need for what? Compilation. On execution, every Apache Pig operator is converted internally into a MapReduce job. But MapReduce jobs will be compiled a lot. Now we'll see the difference between Pig and SQL, because SQL has come to the picture. Now you should supposed to know the difference between the Pig and SQL. Pig Latin is a procedural language. It's not a declarative language like SQL. It has the procedures. I mean, it has, you know, user-defined functions. So when the concept of functions are coming, where? In the Pig, it has user-defined function. It has system-defined function also. Yes, so Pig, we can write down a big Pig script by using user-defined functions also. And in Apache, schema is optional. You can create a schema by using as keyword. You'll go through later. You can create a schema, or without creating schema also, you can keep on executing, loading and storing stuff in Pig. But that thing is not possible in SQL. In SQL, first you have to create the schema by using create table. Create table, table name, within the bracket you write down the schema, right? Which the name of the column and the data type of the columns. It's the mandatory. Schema writing is mandatory in SQL to do any operation with the table. But for Pig, it is not mandatory. It is optional. The capacity is there, but it's not made mandatory. Now, in Pig, one table can have another table inside there. But for SQL, it is flat relational model. It means that one table cannot be containing another table. But two tables can be connected by using the foreign key concept in SQL. Correct, now, but in Pig, we can create one table inside another table. So nested table concept, nested relational concept is provided, that this data model is supported in Pig. Yes, but one thing in SQL advantage is that the SQL provides lots of the optimization techniques. Pig has very limited, you know, query optimization techniques, because Pig queries are internally optimized by MapReduce. So it has not provided much capacity for you to optimize the code. Having said that, it doesn't mean that Pig is inferior to SQL. No, nothing like that. This is what Pig is, and this is what SQL is. SQL also has its own advantages in relational database management system that you are not ignoring, that you are not denying, but you are telling about the Pig right now. Correct? And its advantages. So we'll go through with the Pig and Hive. Those who have known about the Hive is another programming language. It's the Apache product only. For what? For big data analytics only. So Hive and Pig is also having some differences. Like the Pig is use a programming language called Pig Latin. Yes, Pig Latin is created by Yahoo, as we have discussed. But for Hive, it's completely different. It is having a language known as the HiveQL, like SQL, structured query language. Like we have the programming language provided by Hive architecture, that is HiveQL, Hive query language. Hive query language is officially created by Facebook, unlike Pig Latin, which was created by Yahoo. Pig Latin is a data flow language, but HiveQL is exactly like SQL. It's a query processing language. Yes? Now HiveQL is like SQL. It's a declarative language, but Pig Latin, as I told before, it's a procedural language. Apache Pig can handle structured, unstructured and semi-structured data, as you have discussed before. But Hive is actually and most properly designed for structured data only. Hive is actually very much closer to SQL than Pig. And it's too much similar to the SQL only. Hive is too much similar to the SQL only. When we'll go to the Hive, we'll learn it in detail. So now we'll go and get inside the Pig architecture. Yes, inside the Pig we are going now. We're learning about the Pig architecture. As you can see over here, as you can see, so this Pig Latin script, follow my cursor, this Pig Latin script is written over here. That can be executed in two ways. One is by the grunt shell. Grunt shell is like for Windows operating system, you can write down CMD, right? And the command prompt will be open. Similarly, for Pig, we have a shell. That shell is known as the grunt. So if you start the grunt shell, grunt will be written, then greater than sign will be provided. After this greater than sign, whatever you will type, that will be the Pig Latin command. Yes, and Pig server is for the Java specific things. Yes, that Pig Latin script can be executed by Pig server also. Now we have parser. What's the parser is? Parser will check a particular Pig Latin script's syntax. It will check the type, you know, the type checking and the other checking will be done by the parser. The output of parser will be a directed acyclic graph. Then programming language specific statements and logical operators, it will output. That output will go to the optimizer. Optimizer will get that directed acyclic, why it is telling that acyclic graph? Because the graph will not having any cycle in between. So it will be a flow, data flow I'm telling. Na? So if there is a cycle, then that cannot be a data flow actually. So directed acyclic graph, it will be passed the data to the logical optimizations. So for this logical optimizer, it will do two operations actually. One is the projection, another is the push down to the compiler. Now compiler will do the actual thing. That is, this optimized logical plan which has been received by the optimizer will be converted to a MapReduce jobs. And then execution engine will execute those MapReduce jobs. So this compiler basically does the most important thing. What it does, it converts the Pig Latin script to the map and reduce task of MapReduce. And execution engine will just simply, MapReduce jobs will be submitted to Hadoop in a shorted way. And in the Hadoop, by using the HDFS as a data storage, it will execute this MapReduce code. So the Pig Latin script will be converted and will be executed as the MapReduce script on the top of the Hadoop architecture, Hadoop distributed programming architecture. So that's the basic things about the architecture of Pig. Now we'll see that Pig execution. Pig can be executed in two ways. One is the local mode, another is the HDFS mode. In case of local mode, it's all like the local operating system. So whatever the operating system you're using, that operating system's file system will be used if you execute it in local mode. So as you can understand that local mode is actually for testing a particular Pig project or Pig programming or Pig Latin scripts or user defined functions, whatever you say. You want to check, if you want to test it, you can use in the local mode. But if you want to get the true distributed and the full capacity of the big data analytics, then you have to execute it on top of the HDFS. So then you have to execute it on top of the HDFS. So it can be executed Pig into two ways. One is the local mode, another is the HDFS mode. Correct, na? And this local mode and HDFS mode, both the modes can be executed in this three ways. So total combination is 6 different combinations we have. You should focus right now. That either we can execute in local mode, that will be, suppose you have a Ubuntu operating system. So that's the Unix file system only, right? On top, you want to execute Pig and in the local mode. So it will use Unix file system only. It will not go to the HDFS for data storage or storage of the, you know, tables or storage of the data or storing the data. It will not go to the HDFS. So Hadoop is not required to be installed if you want to execute in local mode. But if you want to execute in the HDFS mode, the Hadoop daemons should be running and should be installed. And it should be put on the HDFS, and then only the executions can be started in the HDFS. Now, if you want to execute in local or HDFS, in both the mode, you will get three features. You can execute the Pig by using interactive mode, batch mode, or embedded mode. In case of interactive mode, as the name implies, interactions between the user and the grunt shell will be there. Grunt shell is what? Grunt shell is the shell, that is the command prompt kind of thing for Pig programming language, for the Pig Latin programming language. So that is the interactive mode. Suppose 10 lines of code, first you want to get, I mean, the load a particular file. So you can first write down a command for loading. That command is executed. Next, you want to read some part of the file. So you can give the read command for that. Then the file will be read. Then you want to write down some data. So you are giving the write command in the grunt shell. Then the data will be written with some values. And then you want to close the file. So you have to give command on the grunt shell for closing the file. Then the file will be closed. So it's like the interaction between the grunt shell and the user. The second mode of execution is that batch mode. In case of batch mode, you write a script. A script is a specific file. In that file, all the commands will be given, all the data flow commands will, based on the Pig Latin programming language will be written over there, and you execute at once. That is the batch mode of execution. The next mode of execution is embedded mode. What's in the embedded mode of execution? You request user-defined function for that. You write user-defined function in different programming language, and you embed the Pig user-defined functions to those programming languages like Java, Python, JavaScript, and three other programming languages which it supports. So in this three way, and in combination of local mode and HDFS mode, in these six different ways, we can execute Pig Latin programming. How the Pig Latin is executed? See, Pig Latin is used to express the data flow, and the data flow happens. An execution environment is what? On top of HDFS and or on top of the local system. A single JVM will be executed on that. So we have the execution in the script mode, in the grunt mode, that is the interactive mode, and in the embedded mode, that is the user-defined function mode. Yes, these things has been explained to you. So we'll see that how to invoke the grunt shell, that is how to start the grunt shell. So first we'll see about the local mode and MapReduce mode. To start the local mode, you can just write down this specific command, pig-x:local. Then it will start the grunt shell in the local mode. See, there is nothing specific to HDFS. But if you want to make something specific to HDFS, you have to execute this command, .pig-x:MapReduce, then it will start on the HDFS mode. Now also grunt shell is started, and that time also grunt shell was started. But here it was started in the local mode, it's using the Unix file system. Here, I mean, if you use the Ubuntu, and if you use over here, it will executing on the HDFS file system. Yes, if you want to close the grunt shell, exit from the grunt shell, you have to click Ctrl+D. So this is the grunt, this sign will be generated. This is known as the grunt shell. Yes, after invoking the grunt shell, you can execute a Pig script by directly entering the Pig Latin statement. So one example is given over here. See this, customers will hold what? It will hold this the output of this particular command. What is this command as? Load. We are loading something. What we are loading? Customers.txt. This file we are loading. How? Using the Pig storage comma. So in the customers.txt, whatever the values are there, if the comma appears there, then that will be separated and it will be loaded to customers in this particular file. Yes, so that is how the very simple execution of a grunt shell, execution of a Pig Latin in a grunt shell. Here we are doing something else. We are executing Apache Pig in script in batch mode. For that, what you require, we have to create a .pig file. Like for Java, we use .java extension. For Pig, we use .pig extension. You have might have used Python, so use .py extension. If you have used C, then use .c extension. For C++, we write .cpp extension. Similarly, for Pig programming language specific script, we write down name of the file .pig. Yes, are you clear? So we have written a code over here. See, a Pig script is written, sample_script.pig. So this script is having these three lines only. What is there? It is loading something from the HDFS. From this particular file, which is stored in the HDFS, in the folder, within the folder pig_data, it is loading that file using the Pig storage comma. So whenever some comma will appear in this particular file, student.txt, it will take separately and add in this particular schema. So this is the schema. We are writing as. When you are writing as, after that you are giving this statement, it's making a schema. Table like schema. This table has three columns, ID, name, and city. ID will store only integer values, name will store only character array values, and city will store also character array values. So student.txt will be read in this way, and for each comma value it will store in ID. Next comma will appear, that value will be in the name. Next comma will appear, that will be stored into the city. And then dump student will is like the printf in C or system.out.println in Java. It will dump the data of the student, whatever the things has been read and stored into the student, that will be printed into the out, that will be dumped, that is, that will be printed into the output screen. Let me come over there, wait a minute. Yeah. Yes. So how to execute that particular script? The script is written now. So to execute that script, you can just go to the local mode and write in this way: pig dash x space local. So you are writing in the local mode. So this file should not be in the SDFS. So it should be, this student.txt should be in the local file system. sample_script.pig. So then only this local mode will execute. This file student.txt, so this line should not be there. SDFS part should not be there. And if you want to be there in the SDFS, then this mode you have to execute: pig dash x space MapReduce space sample_script.pig. This will execute this particular lines of code. This particular lines of code will be executed for that. Are you clear? Yes. So this is how pig batch mode execution can happen. Next, we'll see about the grunt, that is the interactive mode. I just told you before something that we'll see over here. See, in the grunt mode, how you are doing it? You are writing something. Correct? You are loading customer.txt into customer's file, order.txt into the orders file, and employee.txt into the employee file by separating using the pig storage. There is a system defined function, okay, pig storage, which will separate the values based on the value of comma. So that we are doing one by one, we are interacting with the grunt shell, correct? So that's why it is known as the interactive mode or grunt mode. Then if you click on the, if you write down history and press enter, it will give you the all the history of the commands which you have executed. This is an execution of the interactive mode. Now we'll see about the embedded mode. Yes, for embedded mode, it requires actually advanced knowledge, because you have to embed the pig Latin script inside any other supported programming languages. 6 programming languages are supported. You have to execute over there. So an example we are giving with Java. So if you don't know Java at all, then it will be very difficult for you to understand. I hope that most of you know Java programming language. So you can see that we have a method, public static void run query. The method name is run query. It is taking pig server space pig server. So pig server, see, pig server is what? It's a system defined method. Pig is a class. We are creating an object of the pig server from the, in the public static void main, in the main method. So this will execute first, right? So this object is created, pig server. And while creation in the single parameterized constructor, we are passing exec type dot MapReduce. So we are executing this particular Java embedded, you know, pig Latin script in MapReduce code. So we are calling the run query method and passing this object. So we'll go to the run query method now. So we are getting this pig server object. Now pig server dot register query. See, in this particular object, now we are registering the queries. The first query is this particular query. So this query is what? It can be executed in the grunt cell, right, in interactive mode. But this all queries all together, how many queries are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 different queries are there. I'm not going inside the queries. Okay, it's the word count query actually. Word count program of pig Latin script. Like you have learned about the MapReduce word count program. It is such a big program, right? Only it can be defined in these 6 lines of code in pig Latin. So in this 6, I'm not explaining all these things. I just want to show you how to execute pig Latin in user-defined function, using user-defined function in embedded mode. So these lines of codes are provided over there. These lines of codes are provided. This can be provided in the script also, pig script also. It can be done in pig, you know, interactive query processing using the grunt shell also. But we are providing this query in this particular programming language. And we're putting inside the try block, that if any exception happens, it will catch by this catch block and it will be printed the print stack. So after the query is run, we are getting the properties here. So we're getting the props. This is the object of the properties class. This class are automatically available. Okay, I'm not writing those things. I have not written all these packages here. Yes, just to make the thing simple. Now props, this object dot set property, fs.default.name. So this is the file system name, HDFS file system name. that we'll get from the property file. When you learned Hadoop installation, you see that what is fs.default.name, right? In a particular file, you updated the value. So those values will be taken. Similarly, these values are also taken. Localhost 9000. So there it will be executed. Are you clear? So all this run query method will execute all these queries, and it will count what? It will get the input. From the input file, it will load the character. Here it will flatten by using the flatten method and the flatten function and tokenize function, the words, and the words will be grouped over here by using the group operator, group command, and then by using the for each particular unique words, we are counting the words, and then we are printing the words over here into the, and we are here you are storing the number of unique word and their count into the this particular file, which will be in the HDFS only. Why it is in the HDFS? Because we are executing in MapReduce, so everything will be the HDFS only. That's why you are setting this HDFS property. Actually, they are fs.default.name and this particular localhost number. And this part is also put inside the try block, because in any execution happens, it will be caught. The program will not stop it normal flow. So how to run this embedded pig? That's the big task actually. You cannot run it very simple way. You have to go through with some IDE, then you have to create a Maven project. Suppose you are using Eclipse, then from Eclipse you have to create a Maven project. You have to create a jar file of this particular external this coding. This particular Java program will be there, na? For this word count, whatever the program I'm showing right now. So this embedded mode UDF has to be converted to a jar file, and then you have to execute. If you execute, you will get its job done. So in this three way, we can execute a pig program. Now we'll learn about the data models in pig. So data models are very interesting in pig and very easy actually. There are four types of the data models. One is the atom. Atom is like integer, float, characters, any specific and small numbers are atom data models. Now we have tuples. Tuples are nothing but a single row. In DBMS term, when you say a table has a row, so that row, what is a row actually? It has value for all of its column names, either null or zero, or some value will be there, right? For all of the column. So that is the tuple. But here in pig, tuple is a row, but it is not mandatory to provide value for each and every columns. A tuple, a row in pig, which can have flexible number of columns and their values. Now we have the bag. Bag is nothing but a collection of tuples. Bag is a collection of tuples. And what is a map? Map is key value pairs. Map is what? Key value pairs. So these four we'll learn first one by one. Atom is a simple atomic value data. Yes, it's stored as a string but can be used as either as a string or a number. A tuple is an ordered set of fields, a row. A bag is a collection of tuples. And a map is a set of key value pairs. See this. This is a tuple. 001 Rajiv 21 Hyderabad. This is what? It's a tuple. All the things 001 Rajiv 21 Hyderabad, 002 Omer 22 Kolkata, 003 Rajesh 23 Delhi. All the things are what? All together it can be a bag. Yes, or a subset of this can also be called as a bag. Here in this example, we have kept all three tuples together to create a bag. And this Delhi is a field. It's an atom. Yes, bag is a collection of tuple, map is a set of key value pairs. So these things has been explained in detail. So an atom is Raja or 30. Here, Rajiv 22, 003 or Hyderabad, all are atoms. Correct? A single value in pig Latin, irrespective of their data, is known as the atom. General, by default, is stored as string and can be used as a string and number also. Int, long, float, double, character array, byte array, is also atomic values of pig. What is a tuple? A record that is formed by an ordered set of fields is known as a tuple. A tuple is similar to a row in a table in RDBMS. Example is Raja, 30. So it's a tuple, it become a tuple. Raja alone is an atom, 30 alone is an atom, but Raja, 30 as it's a part of a row, then it is a tuple. Bag is an unordered set of tuples. Keep this in mind, unordered set. It's not mandatory to be an ordered. Yes, in other words, a collection of tuples that is non-unique is known as the bag. Yes, each tuple can have any number of fields. That is a flexible, the schema is flexible. Any number of fields. Yes, a bag is represented by curly brackets. See this example, Raja, 30, Muhammad, 45. This is a bag, because this is a tuple and this is a tuple. A bag can be a field in a relation. In that context, it is known as inner bag. See this, it's an inner bag. Raja, who is having the age 30, is having this mobile number and this email ID. So inside this particular bag, we have another bag. Yes, so this inner bag is like a field. This inner bag with the mobile number and email ID is like a field to this bag, Raja, 30. Correct? So it's a bag. A relation is like the bag of all tuples. The relation in Pig Latin are unordered. There is no guarantee that tuples are processed in any particular order. Then we have map. A map is what? Key value pairs. Always keep this thing in mind. The map term in Pig refers to the key value pairs. The key will be a character array and should be unique. All keys should be unique. The value can be any type and cannot be unique, because two keys can have the same values. It is represented using the third bracket. Like for bag, it is represented by second bracket. Yes, and a tuple is represented by first bracket. See, a tuple is represented by, see this, is represented by a single bracket, in the first bracket. Bag is represented by curly bracket, so second bracket. And map is represented by the third bracket. See, here the key is name and the value is Raja. Then key is age and the value is 30. And it is provided all within third bracket. So these are the basics of Pig programming language. I'm not going to get in details. So if you have any doubt from these sections, you can put in my video as a comment, or you can have my official email ID. You can send me messages, emails. I mean, I can respond to you back from there. So if you have any doubts relating to the Pig programming language, the Pig architecture, please ping me over there. Thank you. Thank you very much.